Hey everyone, and welcome to another Brew Day, finally. It's been a hot minute since I've been able to upload a video. I have been brewing a bunch, but I just haven't had time to do videos of anything because of kids and school and all that. So, but behind me I have my new system, which I'm doing 10 gallons now at a time, 10 to 12 gallons depending on the beer. So that's giving me two small corny kegs every time I brew. It's been really nice. It's been a little bit of an adjustment in recipe. So today what I thought I would do is show how I throw together what I call a kitchen sink lager. We all hit that point where we've got just a little bit of grain left of a bunch of different kinds of grain. And so I kind of just put a recipe together using what I had. I'm not doing anything special to my water. The water where I live is pretty good for beer, so you know, you may have to do something. And then as far as hops, I'm keeping it real simple with just some German noble hops. The recipe will be listed down below. I think my strike water is ready to go, so let's go ahead and dough in.
Later.
Kind of hard to see because of the sunlight here, but probably the best addition I've made is the wort granite. Basically, Your mash drains underneath, it comes up and flows out. And it prevents suction down on the grain bed. And any little grain bits usually stay in here and don't go through the pump. So, that's clarity.
1 hour later.
Alright, so mash up is complete. I'm gonna be transferring this over to the kettle now. This is mostly gravity until it gets to the end, so it takes quite a while to get done, but alright, we're nearing the boil. Got the first wort hops in. My chiller was being stupid, so I hooked up to my glycol coil and just hooked a hose in and out up to it and chilled down and got it down to 83. Now we're going to use glycol to get it down to the 50 degree range for the lager yeast that I have. So. Well, we're close enough to temp to go ahead and pitch that in. It's at 53. Pardon my chiller. Go ahead and pitch this in and then we'll be good to go. Alright, well that is all done, and so now we're going to wait a couple weeks and let it ferment, and then I'll probably transfer it to kegs after week two and store it in my lagering fridge for 3 to 5 months, I guess. Other than that, I guess we'll see you at the tasting video. Cheers!